Hello, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to a rather windy King Track and Field Stadium, as we have a good soccer match here for you on Saturday afternoon between the Huntington Foresters and the number 4 ranked Spring Arbor Cougars. Huntington has their hands full today with the Cougars. This is only their second home game of the season, and they're going to be paired with, like I said before, the number 4 ranked team in the country. They are undefeated thus far with only one tie. The interesting thing is, in that singular tie, that was the only goal they gave up all season. So it's going to be interesting to see how the Foresters can't compete with that. And try to win. For one thing, the Foresters might need to do is they're going to have to control the ball and keep it at their pace. They cannot let this offense of Spring Arbor into the box. They have 11 players thus far who have been credited with a goal. So if they are able to keep the ball out of the hands of Spring Arbor, that will be best. Not a good start as their opening kick goes out of bounds. So now the Cougars will get an opportunity in the box, and it sails out off the foot of a Forester. This one sails into the box, and the first stop of the game there for the Foresters. Ireland Arney in the box today for Huntington. Arney having a pretty good season, replacing Maddie Moan, who was redshirting this season. She has played all 565 minutes of Forester action and has a save percentage of .919. Two wins, two losses, and two ties with three shutouts. So a shutout would be huge today against this powerful offense. That ball sailed out yet again, so a throw-in opportunity here for the Cougars as they move the ball around in a triangle formation. Beckel had that one. This one will be crossed to Bollering, and the Foresters clear it back to Cotton. Ball split through a handful of people, so now the Foresters will take possession as Sanderson has this on the other side of the field. Ball kicked back to the defense. To Cotton. This ball moved over towards the box. Got a little bit of an opportunity here for the Cougars. That one sails in, and an early goal for the Cougars within the first 3 minutes, just the way they wanted to start. Exactly as I previously stated, the Foresters just need to watch out. They cannot control the ball like this. This is a high-powered offense. You cannot give them opportunities like that. Madison Marshall credited with that goal, her third on the season. Foresters needing to be careful here as they're keeping this ball towards the goal. A turnover could turn devastating. ball kicked out, and the Foresters have a throw-in opportunity here. Sanderson was not going to waste any time, but the gentleman who threw her the ball threw it over her head, so a little bit of a missed opportunity there, as Sanderson will let another one roll out. She tries to throw it in, and it'll be headed off. And that ball clear for another Forrester throw-in. Wind dying down a little bit here in King Track and Field Stadium. Opportunity is squandered there as Sierra hit the deck. That's one thing. A lot of rain here recently in the Forest as that one just sails over the net. But a lot of rain in Huntington the last couple of days, projected 3 inches. So the Huntington, this is a natural grass field. So the Foresters and the Cougars are going to have to watch out for any potential slip and falls and ball move, especially because Spring Arbor does, home field is turf. It is an adjustment they are going to have to make. That ball sailed into the net, and another Forester hits the deck. But the ball carried, so the Foresters have an opportunity. That one sailed blocked! A handball has been called. So that would make... Actually, they were looking for the handball. Thought it was called, but it'll just be a corner kick as they have an opportunity here. Lexi Postine will take this. Ponstein will take this one, and it is headed to the right. Another corner kick coming on the opposite side of the field. That one sailed, knocked out of the air, and that one did go off a Cougar, so it will be a goal kick. Great block there. That one will be another save. As Arnie has her work set out for her today. That one skied in the air. Sanderson cannot track this one down. It is another throw-in opportunity. Ball being moved around here. towards midfield. The Cougars doing a great job charging the box as that one will be cleared and picked up by the Cougars yet again. Foresters just struggling to gain possession. Not a lot of work from the keeper for Spring Arbor. Goal kick coming for the Foresters. Large part of this Cougar success is the Ponsteins. Lexi, number 15, has 2 goals and 5 assists on the year. And Emily is keeper with a 9.929 save percentage. Into the box here, threads the needle, and the Foresters will be there to pick that one up. As Arnie gets a free kick. Mary Cotter comes into this game. That ball crossed the box. No one was there to grab it. Official's discretion on who gets this one, and they'll give the goal kick. Degrees with the wind going at 11 miles per hour west here in the forest. So weather factors will play a role today. As the ball being continued to be moved. Charge into the box by the Cougars, and another save there for Ireland. Ball moved into the box and kicked away, and the Foresters give the ball right back to the Cougars. That ball goes just a bit right. Ball moved in, kick, and that one goes high. Shot on goal there for Madison Marshall, who loves to take shots. She has 15 shots on the season, 2 goals, a 133 shot percentage, 8 of them on goal. Foresters have the ball on their side of the field, suffocating the Cougar defense is. As another throw in for the Foresters. They're in the 14th minute. As the Bronstein finally gets some work, but an easy rejection for her. And goal to goal will allow Arnie to pick that one up. Both teams having really interesting and incredibly difficult schedules coming up as the Sanderson gets called for a foul there. She has to get back on defense. This Crossroads League is particularly tough this year. Coming up, the Spring Arbor really has to test themselves, especially if they want to keep that top five ranking. They have on Wednesday, they are going to Marion, who is number seven, a certain must-watch for Crossroads League women's soccer fans. Then on next Saturday, they have Grace, and then it's on the road again at Taylor, who is receiving votes. And for HU, they obviously have this game against Spring Arbor today. Then they have receiving votes Taylor on Wednesday. Then next week they have Mount Vernon, which is the homecoming game. We'll be broadcasting that one. And then they have number 16 at Grace. Then they're here at King Track and Field Stadium for number 10 Indiana Wesleyan. And then they're going to wrap out this really intense stretch with three games to go at that point against the number seven ranked Marion University. Ball still out of bounds. Throw in for the Cougars. Ball is sailed. They throw in coming from the Foresters. They try to get a little bit of offense going. A surprising penalty kick will be issued. There was a tackle of sorts, but it certainly was towards the end line. I don't know if that was an opportunity for a goal, so a difficult challenge. Mackenzie Selvis will take the kick. She has not attempted a PK yet this season, but does have four goals. Arnie bouncing around, waiting for the kick. A little bit of discussion. Not sure if HU's trying to argue it. They will not. Here comes the kick, and it sails in. Selvis gets the goal, her fifth on the season, and the Cougars have a 2-0 lead with 27 minutes left. Welcome back. Sorry about the technical difficulties there. 2-0 the score off a penalty kick. Headed off. That one kicked off, and an opportunity here for the Cougars will be a penalty kick coming up. It's an open look there, was kicked a little wide. We are in the 20th minute. Annika Arsenault coming into this game. She has 2 goals on the season. 11 players on this Spring Arbor squad have gotten a goal as Arnie pokes that one away and falls on it. Going to sky that one towards the left side and it will go back to the Cougars. Sailed out of bounds. Now the Foresters will get a throw in.
Yep, that was the Irish.
Paul Makeda gives chase to this one. That one sailed in and Arnie scoops it up. Arnie took a shot there, no call. Surprise, no call there. Arnie took a shot. She went up for the ball. The ball was over her head and just ran straight into an attacker from Spring Arbor. That ball sailed wide and it'll be a goal kick. Foresters tried to generate a shot on goal. Slight delay, and they're going to kick that towards the right side, a crowded right side. With an opportunity here. Squandered as the Cougars now have the ball in their attacking zone. Arnie calls off the dogs and picks this one up. that ball. Sail toward midfield. That ball sailed right to Arnie. As by the end of this game, she may be the leader in saves in the Crossroads League. That ball sail. Foresters have chase here. They miss kick. Sanderson has this one and turns the ball over. Foresters just let that ball go. It never left out of the out of bounds line. They were expecting a throw in, but it just kind of stayed put. That ball moved and it will stay in the box, so the Foresters have to clear this one. Sail towards the goal, and Arnie gets in the breadbasket. High flying kick will be missed. Throw in opportunity here for the Cougars as they try to take this one. That ball sailed away. Goal kick, goal, first shot on goal for the Foresters will be taken away as Arnie grabs this one. A little bit of confusion on whose goal kick that was, or free throw, throw in. But it will be the Foresters.
15 minutes remaining. And Ponstein gets a little bit of work. Forrester try to set something up. That ball's going to be quite high over the crossbar. This ball will be sailed. And Arnie's there to pick it up. That's a high short kick there. These division rival schools with HU and Spring Arbor are getting a little bit of a workout today. Obviously right now we have this women's game. At 3 o'clock, the volleyball teams will be facing off in Spring Arbor. And just following that game, it will be the heated rivalry of HUMS versus Spring Arbor MS. A lot of history there, as in 2018 and 19, the Foresters won back-to-back Crossroads League tournaments on Spring Arbor's field. In 2019, Spring Arbor won the regular season championship right here at King Track and Field Stadium. And then last year in the first round, teams that were used to playing each other in the championship ended up playing each other in the first round, and the Foresters came up short in that one. Coach Lawson wasn't too keen. Losing in the first round, went out and got a good recruiting class. As he tries to charge back to the Crossroads League Championship and to the National Championship Tournament. Spring Arbor has won national championships in basketball and soccer in the past few years. Whistle sounds as a tie-up will lead to a Forrester free kick. This ball sailed in. Opportunity. The Foresters there in their own box, and it gets kicked away, but the Foresters still have possession. Great defense there by the Cougars. Patrick has to give this one chase. She barely keeps it in bounds, but it's back in Cougar possession, and the Cougars defense comes up for them again. Sarah Disbro comes into this ball game. Oh.
9 minutes and 55 seconds remaining in this game. As the Foresters try not to get blanked in this first half. Corner kick coming off of a great block there. That was Alex Bryant who got laid her body on the line. Corner coming way high. Headed off, and it will leave the box, but Cougar's still in possession. That ball sailed and blocked by Arnie! Sent that one over the bar, so it will be a corner kick, but what a great, that one had some velocity on it. She got her hands on it and kept it above the bar. Corner incoming, that one sailed high and it will go right, and a goal kick coming for the Foresters. Substitutions here. Forrester trying to bring in some speed. Cougars send this one back to their defense. Foresters can charge the ball and try to get a change of possession and get a 2-on-1. That ball went to the right of the net. Foresters and Cougars bringing in some reinforcements down the stretch. Abby Adams comes into this game. Intercepted by the Foresters, and they're trying to switch field. A little bit of a shove off there. The Foresters.
And for the Foresters, number 23, Deegan Phillips.
Keegan Phillips comes into this game. Five under five to go. Forster's looking to charge onto this one. Cougar's going to send it back to the keeper. This ball moved in. Collision here. Forrester's keeping possession of this ball. Having difficulty moving it towards the net. This one moved in. Arnie hits the deck and a wide open goal for the Cougars with 2:50 to go. Leaving the score to 3-0. Arnie hit the deck and it was all wide open pastures for the Cougars. Cougars lead 3-0. Force is going to try to get a little bit of momentum back and keep this game close going into the half. As the Foresters and the Cougars try to battle for this one on defense. That one sails out of bounds. And it'll be a free throw for Abby Adams. Blocked away by Adams. So the Cougars will keep possession with 1 minute to remaining in the quarter. That one sailed out of bounds again. That's the ball boy on the right side working extra hard today. And that one will be a goal kick for the Foresters. 40 seconds to go. As this is their Hail Mary attempt to get on the board. 17 seconds as the Foresters are probably just going to look to dribble this one out. That one's out of bounds, and that should do it as the countdown begins. A 3-0 quarter for the number 4 ranked Cougars. As the horn sounds, both teams go back to the locker room and different states of excitement for this for the second half. We'll have to see what the Foresters can do. Try to come back into this one. We'll be right back on FTN Sports for halftime analysis.
the shots on goal. You have to give so much credit to Ireland Arnie. As she has 14 saves on the day. Spring Arbor took 24 shots. The Foresters took one. This ball moved towards the box. Cougars got a quick goal last time. That ball sails and skied in the air. And Arnie is there for that one. That ball kicked out. Will be a Forrester throw in. Ashlyn Patrick will take it. Sanderson's going to charge the right side of the box. And that ball intercepted. Cougars looking for an open look. Ireland will watch that one sail over the crossbar. Foresters have this one. Patrick tries to move it towards midfield. She gets taken down and a foul called. Sail to the left side of the field. Open look here for Marshall. And another goal! That's goal number four on the day. For the Cougars. Marshall will be credited with that goal. Her third on the season. Fourth on the season, actually. Second on the day, I believe. That's correct. That'll be her second on the day. She's one away from the hat trick. move towards the box here. Opportunity here for the Cougars. Patrick hits the deck and keeps that one. The Spring Arbor team also has quite the tradition of women's soccer and a very notable alumni. Bethany Baser is a SAU alumni. She was the rookie of the year for the Rain out of Tacoma, Washington, of the National Women's Soccer League. She said on her Twitter account that she was proud to be a Cougar. Foul called. Patrick has this ball. She's going to try to move it back up the field. She kicks it across the field to the right side. That ball in for another goal! Ariana Stolfos has the goal there. Her second on the year, first on the day. Not even 10 minutes into the second half. Cougars moving the ball towards the box again. Attempted kick there, curved, kind of like a banana. Cougars were looking for a call of a little bit of a semi-tussle near midfield. Foresters charged the box, but it will remain Cougar ball. Saved by Arnie there, her 16th of the day. That ball was a line drive, not a lot of spin on it, but certainly got the distance. Arnie with another save there. It was a cross box save. Turned over once again by the Foresters. Appears as if the Cougars are going to start putting in a little bit of their bench, which gives the Foresters a conundrum if they also want to put in their bench and try to get a couple goals. Or if they should also just throw in their bench and get these girls rested for a tough part of the schedule. Another turnover. This ball being moved in. Patrick takes it away. Ball being moved in towards the box. Almost tripped up there. 33 minutes remaining. That ball moved in and Arnie has an easy save. Mary Cotter comes into this game. Foul call there. We'll set up with a free kick just outside the box for the Cougars. That ball moved in. Arnie has to go up for it, and the header just sails. And that'll be a foul, and so the Foresters will get a free kick, which also doubles as a goal kick. Two for one here at King Track and Field Stadium. Line drive. That ball kicked off. It'll be a throw in for the Foresters. With 30 minutes to go on this one. Ball moved into the box. That ball still out of bounds for a Forester throw-in. Ashton Patrick will take it. Foresters taking shots to the face. That ball cleared by the Foresters. We'll go back. Foresters give chase. Ponstein did some work there. Arnie getting another goal kick here. Just gonna have to bust out the Tylenol after this game with all the work she's had to do. That ball sails out of bounds, and the Foresters get another throw in. it coming here.
Oh, that's normal.
Oh, yeah.
Corner kick coming here. That ball crossed and it will go wide, and a goal kick coming. More substitutions here for the Foresters. Ireland's gonna take another goal kick. 25 minutes remaining in this one. Ball moved towards the box. Foresters get it away. Throw in here for the Cougars. They try to get another goal. Add to their season goal differential. Like I said before, they've only given up one goal all season. Unfortunately for them, they couldn't grab a second goal during that game. But 5-0 since that day. This team was a serious national title contender, looking to make their statement as one of the top teams in the Crossroads League. As I said before, they do have to prove that here in the next coming days. More substitutions for the Foresters. They try to get some fresh legs in there. Cougars charging up the middle. Not so stiff opposition. Throw in here for the Foresters. Try to get a few more shots on goal today. As that ball sails out. Patrick sends that one towards midfield.
As the
that ball sailed in, blocked by the Foresters. Cougars looking for a call there as there's a little bit of a hold towards the box. No call given. We are now under 20 minutes remaining. Forrester trying to make something happen here. No dice as the Foresters hit the deck. That ball sails out of bounds. Cougars had an open look there, but unfortunately they were offsides. Arnie takes the free kick from outside her box. No offsides here, but the Cougars gonna charge the box, a collision. With 18 minutes to go, a few more substitutions coming in. Another goal kick here for Arnie. The wind is brutal out here. HU moves this ball out of their box. Cougars looking for a call as there was a tangle up. No call will be given. Appears the officials just going to let them play out this final 15-33. Forrester's trying to get some goals. charge into the box, 2-on-1. Great defense there by the Cougars. Substitutions here. Courtney McCown comes into this game. As Patrick takes the seat. Yet another goal kick for Arnie. Forest is going to throw in as they try to get a late goal. Shot off target. Sanderson charges the box. That one was just about an inch away from crossing the goal line. No dice. Crossed, and Ireland is there for another save on the day. I think it's about time we recognize Ireland as one of the defensive players of the week. Fresh legs coming in for the Cougs. Yes. Cougars kind of dribbling this ball out. They're beginning to reach single digits. A good cross and an open look there for the Cougars. That was Naomi Dune. .8:35 remaining in this ball game. Makata comes into this game. Cougars have a chance here. Adams kicks that one out of bounds. The Foresters just look to dribble this game out. I want to thank you so much for joining us here on FDN Sports. Coming up in Forester action, homecoming week has come, has bestowed this great campus. You're looking for some, your hunger for HU Spring Arbor has not been satisfied yet, you can come go straight to this game to saucougars.com and watch the volleyball team play Spring Arbor. And if your itch still isn't scratched by that point, you could also watch at 7 o'clock Spring Arbor versus HU men's soccer, one of the most heated rivalries in the Crossroads League. But here on FDN Sports, we're transitioning to the month of October, a very exciting month here for us at FDN Sports. On Wednesday, we have Taylor University coming up, a Crossroads League I-9 rivalry matchup. On next Saturday for our homecoming game, we have Mount Vernon coming to town. Once then on the 6th of October, volleyball, Mount Vernon comes to town yet again. Then on the 9th, we got men's soccer versus Grace. And then on the 13th of October, we got women's soccer versus Indiana Wesleyan. Basketball season also charging quickly. Ashlyn Patrick comes back into this game. That ball cleared out. Thank you. attempting to move the ball into the box. Really, the story of the game was, I said during the pregame show that the Foresters would have to control the pace if they wanted to win this game. Unfortunately, the Cougars just, their defense was suffocating, their offense just did not want to give the ball up. So a dominating performance for them. Victory remaining. Cougars move the ball past midfield. This one will go into the box. Ireland charges on it. Cougars not giving up. They're going to play to the horn. Ball moved towards the box, intercepted by the Foresters. With 2:30 remaining, more substitutions coming in. On this windy day, the winds of fortune were just not in favor of Huntington today. Just an example of that in suffocating Cougar defense. Forces charged the box and just nothing was there. That ball moved in. Ireland! Arnie with a great hand save there. Crossroads League Defensive Player of the Week. Mark it now. What a save. That ball looked like it was going towards the back of the net, and she got her hand on it the last second. One minute remaining. Seconds remaining. Marshall credited with two goals on the day. Only one credited save for Ponstein. For the Foresters, 18 saves. for Arnie. Forrester's gonna have to recover for a quick turnaround and a rough break in their scheduling. They got to learn from this game. For producer Dylan Herring, director Matt Fouts, and we had Elliot Martin and Joy Hearsay on camera today. I want to thank you so much for joining us here on FDN Sports. I'm Carson Watkins. Have a great rest of your Saturday. We'll see you next time on FDN Sports.